What's up guys, Sal here. So the Galaxy S21 Unpacked event is finally here. We have tons of high quality hands-on videos of the entire Galaxy S21 lineup, courtesy of Evan Blass, and also the videos of the S Pen as well as the new exclusive features of the Galaxy S21 Ultra. First up, here's the S Pen on the S21 Ultra. As you can see, it looks different than the one we have on the Galaxy Note. It's a little thicker and longer, but it does have all the S Pen features we are used to on the Galaxy Note. Also, since there is no slot to put it on the phone, Samsung has made a custom case where you can place it at the side. Although it will make the case a little wider, especially on the left side, but it's better than having no slot and losing your stylus. The biggest improvement the Galaxy S21 Ultra will see is in the camera department, especially in the zoom. Now the S21 Ultra has two zoom cameras, one is for short range and another is for long range, which helps you take better and high quality 3x and 10x lossless zoom pictures. Also, zooming in over 30x and up to 100x makes the camera shaky, which may get blurry photos. To avoid that, Samsung has created a zoom lock, which you can enable by touching the zoom lock at the left, which basically locks the zoomed in pictures to get clearer photos. Also, the Galaxy S21 has an improved night mode thanks to a new and faster bright night sensor and noise reduction technology. As you can see, the night mode has been significantly improved compared to the Galaxy S20, where now the image is not only brighter but also has more detail. The video is where the S21 Ultra is seeing another major improvement. Now you can record 4K videos from all the lenses. Also, if you're recording in the default auto full HD mode, then the S21 Ultra supports recording of variable FPS from 30 to 60fps, whereas it's fixed on last year's Galaxy S20 Ultra. Also new is the dynamic video on single take, which uses AI to maximize the dynamic motion by slowly playing the part, as you can see in this demo. Other features like Super Steady has been improved as well. Director's View is also a handy tool that shows recording on the screen from all the lenses at the same time, including the front camera, which is gonna be super helpful for video nerds. The Galaxy S21 comes with a free Galaxy Smart Tag, which is basically a tracker you can attach to things like your bag or your car key. Say if you've lost your key, then you can find it with your phone on the SmartThings app, which basically shows you the exact location. Depending upon the strength of the signal, the graphic changes, and still if you don't find it, you can just ring it, which is kinda useful. Also with SmartThings Find app, you can locate the exact location of your lost phone or watch or even the smart tag, which is possible courtesy of the ultra wideband chip. The Galaxy S21 Plus also looks beautiful in this phantom violet color. To keep the cost down, Samsung has trimmed some features on the S21 Plus, such as no periscope zoom camera, a 64 megapixel main sensor, and a flat display up front. Also, the S21 Plus has a Full HD Plus display at 120Hz compared to the Quad HD Plus of the Ultra. Also, the Galaxy S21 looks exactly the same as the Plus, except the back is made out of plastic. The rest of the specs are nearly identical. Samsung will also launch the new earbuds, the Galaxy Buds Pro, along with the S21. And actually, they'll give it away for free if you pre-order the S21 Ultra. It has some new features, such as it will automatically turn down the volume if it detects that you are speaking to someone else, and then automatically turns up the volume. Also, if you have a tablet alongside the phone, it will automatically switch to the gadget that you're using, which is smooth. Of course, with that being said, let me know what you think about this down in the comments. And as always, I'll see you tomorrow. Peace out.